never be more loved than I am right now. Wasn't holding you up, so there's nothing I can do to let you down. It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Ooh.
Going through a storm, but I won't go down. I hear your voice carried in the rhythm of the wind to call me out. You would cross an ocean.
So clear what it's all about.
So stay by my side when the sun goes down. Don't want to forget how I feel right now.
Please open our eyes. Ooh, yeah. exactly what she meant, and then she followed up and said, because I told you so. And I'm praying that you open our eyes.
Oh my God.
I'm praying that you open our eyes again.
Oh Father,
Father, please open our eyes.
What's wrong, and you can make it right with some holy conviction, a little love and correction. You can take these burdens and give us ones that's light. So here I am, Jesus, you can make it right. We won't take it off. won't take it all.
We won't take it all.
Oh, the joy of the Lord.
We won't take it all.
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 We've decided we won't take it all.
Take it all. The joy of the Lord won't take it all. Peace of the Lord, he won't take it all. Power of the Lord, he won't take it all. Yeah. Strength of the Lord, he won't take it all. Spirit of the Lord, he won't take it all. Yeah. I will hold you forever, Lord, close to me, and I won't let go. I will hold you forever, oh God, and I won't let go. Won't let go of your hand. Won't let go of your hand. I'll never let go of your hand. Never let go of your hand, Lord. Never let go of your hand, Lord. I'll never let go of your hand, Lord. I'll never let go of your hand, Lord. I'll never let go of your hand.
Never let go of your hand.
Yes.
Never let go of your hand.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning and welcome to Kingdom Word Ministry, where we preach and teach the Word of God chapter by chapter, verse by verse. Praise God. I'm excited this morning. Praise God. I'm excited to stand before you this morning. Praise God, because I know the Lord has a word for you this morning. Praise God. And I'm so grateful and appreciative to the Lord allowing me to be here this morning with the activities of my limb, and I have a mind and want to praise him and want to serve him and want to lift him up and want to magnify his name this morning. If you love the Lord and you are grateful for what the Lord have already done for you, praise God, tell him thank you and give him a big hallelujah this morning. Praise God. So let's go right into the word. The word will be coming from Genesis chapter 27, verse 5 through 17, beginning with verse 5. And Rebecca heard when Isaac spake to Esau, his son, and Esau went to the field to hunt for venison and to bring it. Rebecca spoke unto Jacob, her son, saying, Behold, I heard thy father speak unto Esau, thy brother, saying, Bring me venison and make me savory meat that I may eat and bless thee before the Lord, before my death. Now, therefore, my son, obey my voice according to that which I command thee. Go now to the flock and fetch me from thence two good kids of the goats, and I will make them savory meat for thy father, such as he loved. And thou shalt bring it to thy father, that he may eat, and that he may bless thee before his death. And Jacob said to Rebekah his mother, behold, Esau, my brother, is a hairy man, and I am a smooth man. My father peradventure will fear me, and I shall seem to him as a deceiver, and I shall bring a curse upon me and not a blessing. And his mother said unto him, upon me be thy curse, my son. Only obey my voice and go fetch me them. And he went and fetched and brought them to his mother. And his mother made savory meat such as his father loved. And Rebekah took goodly raiment of her elder son Esau, which was with her in the house, and put them upon Jacob, her younger son. And she put the skin of the kids of the goat upon his hand and upon the smooth of his neck. And she carried the savory meat and the bread in which she had prepared into the hands of her son Jacob. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity to break bread with your people, God. We thank you, God, and we appreciate the Lord. You allowed us to be here and be able to hear your word and speak your word this morning, praise God. And Father, I just pray now, God, that you have your way, God. Have your way with me. Have your way with your listeners, God. Give them that spiritual ear to hear and to understand your word, because we are assured if this word falls on good ground, it will come up again, God. So let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be accepted in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the body of believers, said, amen. I want to talk to you this morning from part two of our theme, tampering with the word of God. Tampering with the word of God. But I want to place emphasis on attempting to work out God's will before his time. Attempting to work out God's will before his time. We as believers have tampered with the word of God by trying to work out God's will before his time. Many times we walk with God and we have misconstrued and tampered with the word of God. Tampering with the word of God will cause you to live a life deceit, to live a deceitful life. Tampering is not only trying to alter the outcome, it is being deceitful. It is being dishonest. It is attempting to work out God's will before his time. It is a sin. It will cause you to be so wrapped up in what you're doing in your scheme that you will lose sight on what you're doing. And you begin to deviate from the word of God. And when you deviate from the word of God, you are actually tampering with the word of God. Isaac knew the will of God, and Rebekah knew the will of God. And Isaac was going against the will of God. He was going against what God had already said. And by being the head of the family, he was supposed to be the leader of the family. Being the leader of the family, you have to set example. You have to walk according to the word of God if you want to be the leader of the household, praise God. But he was setting a bad example by going against the will of God. The will of God for his two sons was the younger son was to be the stronger of the two. The younger son was supposed to be from the line of Jacob, supposed to be line to the Messiah, praise God, hallelujah. But Isaac met with his elder son privately. He met with Esau. He wanted to bless Esau instead of Jacob. And Rebekah overheard his plan. What she heard was so shocking that it shocked her to the core, because she knew that Isaac knew exactly what God had said, and now he is going against the will of God.
When we look at verse 5, the scripture said Rebekah heard when Isaac spoke to Esau, his son. So she was listening. As a faithful wife, as a faithful mother, praise God, she was listening, but something must have happened over the period of time, because she is not really paying a lot of respect to the husband, because the husband is drifting away from the word of God. Many times when we hear something, praise God, we hear something, but we're not listening. She was listening. Many times when you think your wife is not listening, that's when she is listening. Sometimes she's listening to watch your back, and sometimes she's just doing it to be nosy, praise God. But in this particular time, she was listening because Isaac called Esau privately. And she knew that Isaac loved Esau, praise God. And she knew that was something up, praise God. And she was able to be in a position to hear him say, praise God, hallelujah. She knew that Isaac was being disobedient to the word of God. She knew this, that he was refusing to follow God's will. And when we refuse to follow God's will, and if you are leader of the home, praise God, everybody is looking at you. Everybody is walking. How can you lead if you don't set an example that God is pleased with? Praise God. Hallelujah. She knew Isaac was wrong. She was not about to let Jacob be cheated out of his birthright, cheated out of the blessing which God had planned before he was born, before the twins were born. He knew that, and Isaac knew this, praise God, hallelujah, glory to God. With all the love that Rebekah had, her love was tainted. Her love was tainted. If you lead someone to be deceitful, encouraging them to do evil, then you are your love and your leadership is tainted. Praise God. Rebekah was encouraging Jacob to deceive his father. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We're going to see here that Rebekah, in all of her righteousness and all of her ways trying to work things out for the Lord, was sinning herself. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So when we look at verse 6 and 7, Rebekah had to work quickly to devise a plan. And verse 6 says, when Rebekah spake unto Jacob, her son, saying, behold, I heard thy father speak unto Esau, thy brother, saying, bring me venison and make me savory meat that I may make it and bless thee before the Lord, before my death. Rebekah knew she must act quickly. She had to do something. She had to act quickly, and she had, in all of her acting, praise God, she had to make sure that she could stir the heart of Jacob and get him to go along with her plan. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. She was scheming. See, I remember in a quote what so Walter Scott said. He said, oh, what a tangle web we weave when we first practice to deceive, praise God. Rebekah took matters in her own hands. She resorted to doing something wrong, trying to bring about what God had already said he was going to do, praise God, hallelujah. But Rebekah figured, she figured the end would justify the means. But she figured what she was doing that was not wrong, because she was actually doing what God said was going to happen, praise God. But God don't need you, praise God, to work out his will this morning, praise God. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? No matter how good we think our goals are, we should not attempt to achieve them by doing wrong. Would God approve of what you're doing today and trying to reach your goal? Would he be smiling on you? Would he tell you good and no faithful servant that you're doing exactly what I wanted you to do? Praise God. God would not be pleased with our action this morning. Praise God. Hallelujah. So when we look at verse 8, we see here, now therefore, my son, obey my voice according to which I command thee. Rebecca deception. She put her plan in motion. Anytime, praise God, we get ahead of God, we begin to fall behind with our walk with God. Praise God. Hallelujah. You cannot get ahead of God because he tell you in his word, he said, delight, he tell you to trust in the Lord with all our heart and lean not to your own understanding and all our ways acknowledging and he will direct your path. You can't get ahead of God if you want good success this morning. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? We think that some of our problem can be only worked out and solved when we are mingling, when we are meddling, praise God. We are getting involved, trying to work things out, praise God. And all we need to do is pray. Pray about our situation and yield our life totally to the Lord, praise God. I heard someone this week, praise God, tell me we should work as if all depend on us and pray if all depend on God. Praise God. We need to put all of our desire, all of our trust in God. Praise God. When you have done all you can, praise God, stand therefore, praise God. Hallelujah. And let God work it out. Don't be a deceiver. Don't attempt to do something before God is ready for it to be done. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? Rebecca said, go now in verse 9. She said, go now to the flock. Rebecca gave her son instruction to be carried out. She laid her instruction out, praise God. And she wanted them to be carried out, praise God. She wanted to be deceitful, praise God. Hallelujah. Sometimes our strongest temptation comes from those that we are close to or those that we love, praise God, hallelujah. Adam was tempted by Eve, his wife, to eat of the tree. And now we see Jacob being tempted by his mother to deceive his father this morning. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? Rebecca had a method of achieving God's will. Not God's method, but she had her method to try to and correct what was wrong, praise God. She suggested to Jacob, she said, bring me two goats, two young goats, so I can cook them and make them tasty, just like your father liked, just like that Isaac liked, so he can enjoy it. Praise God. And that tells me something, praise God, that Rebecca had skills. Rebecca could cook a goat, praise God, and make it taste as wild meat, praise God, that Esau was bringing out of the wilderness, praise God. Hallelujah. Jacob, if he did this, Jacob could take it to his blind father and receive the blessing for himself. If Jacob would carry out this plan, praise God, he could receive the blessing for himself because this was done. It needed to be done on this day, praise God. Hallelujah. Rebecca was convinced that her method was just. She said, this is what God wanted to do for Jacob from the beginning. When we get ahead of God's will, we tend to get so tangled up in what we are trying to do and what we want to do that we forget God and fall behind his lead. Praise God. Hallelujah. Rebecca was trying to work out God's will before his time. When we look here at verse 11 and 12, we find that he said, Jacob said to Rebecca, his mother, behold, Esau, my brother, is a hairy man, and I am a smooth man. My father, pre-agent, will feel me, and I shall see him as a deceiver. He said, see me as a deceiver, praise God. And I shall bring him to bring the curse upon me and not a blessing, praise God. He believed this, praise God. It was in his mind. It was in his heart, praise God. And when we find that Jacob was hesitant about doing this, praise God. Jacob was hesitant when he heard Rebekah's deceitful plan, praise God. Although his hesitation was for the right, for the wrong reason, praise God, hallelujah. He wanted to hesitate, but he was hesitating for the wrong reason. He wasn't hesitating because he wanted to, that it was wrong. He was hesitating because he didn't want to get caught. Many people say when they get caught, I'm sorry. They want to show some remorse, praise God. But they're only saying that because they got caught. Had they not gotten caught, praise God, they would have went on doing what they was doing. Praise God. Jacob gave his mother a chance to reconsider, praise God. Gave her a chance to move out. Even though his heart might have not been there, he gave his mother a chance to think about what was going on. But Rebecca was so wrapped up in her plan, she was wrapped up in her skin, she no longer was able to clearly see what she was doing, praise God. She was wrapped up, praise God. See, sin will have you trapped, praise God. It'll have you. She was trapped in her credibility and her character was being destroyed, praise God. Hallelujah. Sin is like that this morning, praise God. Yes, sin will get you right at that point, praise God. The Bible said there's pleasure in sin for a season. It will get you to the point. Sin will get you to the point that you feel that there's no way I can turn around. I got to keep going on. See, sometimes when you correct yourself in the middle of doing wrong, it may hurt and may bring disappointment, but it also will bring freedom from the sin of its control, praise God. We must resist the devil. The Bible said resist the devil and he will flee from you this morning. If you have problems in your life and you see things that are trying to tempt you and drift you away from the word of God, causing you to try to deceive, causing you to try to do things that are not in line with the word of God, the Bible said resist it, praise God. Tell Satan to get behind you, praise God. When you tell Satan to get behind you, you got to stand, you got to walk as though he's already happen, praise God. Speak it like you believe it, walk it like you're talking, and God will work this thing out. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We see in verse 12, Jacob feared Isaac's curse. He said, if Isaac touch me while we are eating, Isaac would know that he was and not Esau, praise God, hallelujah. He was worried about this thing. He was wrapped up in it, praise God. He knew there was no way this could take place, praise God. The lie and deception would be discovered. He knew that something was going wrong. He would bring a curse and not a blessing upon himself. But Rebecca, praise God, hallelujah. Her mind was made up. She was determined, praise God, to work things out, praise God. In verse 13, she talks about the protection for her scheme, praise God. His mother said unto him, upon me be thou cursed, my son. Only obey my voice. Don't worry about anything. I will take it upon myself, praise God. You got to believe me enough to know that I will stand up before Isaac and tell him to curse me instead of you, because I know this is the will of God, and really it was not the will of God. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? Rebecca did not justify the evil. She only promised protection doing the evil, praise God. However, her promise was reckless and worthless, praise God. For Jacob paid over and over for his deceitfulness of his father, praise God. Now Jacob reaped what he sowed this morning, praise God. Galatians 6 and 7 said, be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man sow, that shall he also reap. Jacob was a deceiver. And he was deceived by Laman, Rebekah's son, Rebekah's brother, praise God. He was deceived over and over by Laman, praise God. He was reaping what he sowed, praise God. If you plant corn, you're not going to get watermelon, praise God. Oh, praise God. It's a natural law to harvest what you plant, praise God. Glory to God. It is true in every phase of life, praise God. If you gossip about your friend, you will lose the friendship, praise God. Every action has a result. No matter what you do, whatever you plant, praise God, it will come back, praise God. If you plant please to your own desire, praise God, you try to please your own desire, you will harvest a crop of sorrow and evil, praise God. But if you plant to please God, you will have harvest of joy and everlasting life, praise God. When you cater yourself to the Lord, when you plant in the word of God and you plant it in your heart, praise God, it will come back up, praise God, with some joy in your heart, joy in your steps this morning. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? What kind of seed this morning are you planting? Will God be pleased with what you planned this morning, praise God? How you've been planning all this week, praise God? Will God be pleased? Will you be getting back what you planted, praise God? Praise God, some of us do not want to get back what we have planted this week. But if you have planted love and happiness and joy, praise God, yes, you're going to get that back, praise God. Whatever you plant, praise God, you can harvest it, praise God. Can we say hallelujah? Glory to God. Many people will sin if they think they would get away with it and would not get caught or would be exempted from punishment. They wouldn't mind sinning. They would keep on sinning. But praise be to God. God sees you, praise God. There's no protection worthwhile from doing evil. God sees all and he judges all, praise God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Rebekah skillfully prepared for every possibility. She prepared for every conceivable thing that could happen. She had to work this thing out in her mind. This just didn't come up on her and she started moving on emotion. She had time to think about what she was doing, praise God. It was premeditated, praise God. Can we say hallelujah? Glory to God. See how skillful she was, praise God. So when we look at verse 14, she prepared to taste the meal requested by Esau, praise God. She had the skills to do and make it taste the way Esau, Isaac wanted to be, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And she also handled the problem of Isaac's keen sense of smell. Praise God. This lady was, she thought of everything, praise God. She ended up, praise God, she ended up taking Isaac's clothes that was in her house and she put it on Jacob. That let me know that Jacob, Esau must have been a person that was in the woods and wilderness, praise God, and didn't bathe that much, praise God. His body smell was all in his clothes, praise God. There was no whole lot of washing, praise God, going on. And Rebekah knew that she could put that smell that Isaac loved, and he, not so much he loved, but he know the smell of Esau, praise God. She put it upon Jacob. Praise God, in verse 15. And we see here that she was able to handle the problem of Jacob's smooth skin. In verse 16, by gluing the goat's skin to his hand and upon his neck, praise God. She was able to do this See, Rebecca had dotted every I and crossed every T. She knew exactly how to be deceitful, praise God. She had worked this thing out, praise God. And all she wanted to do is make sure, praise God, that Jacob was on board. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? See, Rebecca, as she done this and Jacob was on board, she gave to Jacob the meat. And she sent him to Isaac to feed him and to receive the blessing from him, praise God. She did this in verse 17. Rebecca had worked this thing out. She was a deceiver. And if you can be a deceiver, you'll find out as you read later on that Rebecca had her problems because she deceived. She was attempting to work God's will out before time. She was thoroughly convinced that Jacob himself could work God's will out by doing it what she told him to do. She was all about doing what Isaac tried to take from Jacob, praise God, hallelujah. But the problem was, having no trust in God will lead you to tampering with the word of God. Rebecca, trust and faith in God was weak. She needed God's will. She knew God's will, and God had spoken to her and revealed it to her. And she was trying to go before God, and she was told this before God, Jacob was and Esau was born. She was trying to work it out on her own. That she was right in being concerned over Isaac's sin. His scheme to bypass God's will was wrong, and Rebecca knew that. In this case, she was right, but in the scheme of the plan was wrong. She was wrong in not trusting God to work out his will, to work out all these things, praise God. She was wrong in scheming and trying to work out God's will before his time this morning, praise God. When you try to work out God's will before his time, there's always going to be something. Come, we have to be in a position that we have to trust God, that God will work these things out. She was wrong in leading Jacob to lie and deceive his father, praise God. How can you be a mother and how can you be a parent and you're teaching your child to lie? You're teaching your child to be a deceiver, praise God, hallelujah, glory to God. Rebecca's trust and faith in God to work out his will was weak. And we get to the point that we don't believe God can work the thing out. And see, Rebecca was at the point that it was happening on that day. Everything was falling on her that day in her mind. Many times we give up on God when we don't see no way out to the problem can be worked out. When we don't see that God has the time because the time is running out and we need to move and move right now in our mind. But God controls time. But see, because we fail to remember, well, God, all things are possible with him. Rebecca felt that this was it. Isaac was getting ready to change the birthright, and that day was nothing she could do, praise God, but to do what she was doing. But she forgot one thing, praise God. She didn't know that God can do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ask or think, praise God, according to the power that worketh in us. God has the power in us, praise God, to work out salvation, praise God, with fear and trembling this morning, asking God and trusting God to work the situation out. It's never too late with God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Rebecca attempt to work out God's problem before time. We must trust God to work out what he said he was going to do. Trust him to do it. He'll do it. Won't he do it? Praise God. Have he ever done it for you this morning? Praise God. Have he ever done it when you saw no way out? Praise God. And the doctor said there was no hope. Praise God. And God came through. When man says there's no hope, God said there's a way. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God has his own timetable. He knows when the right time is. It may seem like it's over this morning, my brothers and sisters, but God, my God, hallelujah, is a God that's on time God this morning, praise God. He may not come when you want to, praise God, but he's always right on time. He's always there to move on our behalf. We reckon didn't believe God could work it out if Isaac tampered with it, the will of God. She didn't believe it. We must put our trust in God and wait on him, praise God. If he said it, it will come to pass. Don't tamper with the word of God and trying to work out God's will before his time. The Bible tells me in Isaiah 40 and 28 to 31, he said, have thou not known, have thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the end of the world, fainteth not, neither is weary. There's no searching of his understanding. You cannot imagine, praise God, hallelujah, glory to God, the things that God has in store. His thoughts are not your thoughts. His ways are not your ways. He said he give power to the faint. And to them that have no might, he increases their strength. He said even the youth shall faint and be weary, and young men shall utterly fall. Praise God. We will, I don't care how strong you are, how big you are, how young you are, praise God. There's going to be some time that you can't go on. But the Bible says he gives power to the faint. And to them that have no might, praise God, he increases the strength. But the big important thing, he said, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up as wings as an eagle. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint, praise God, hallelujah. God knows that the steps of a righteous man is ordered by the Lord, praise God. No matter who or what you're doing, praise God. God is always there, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. If you want that waiting power this morning that God gives, just ask him to give it to you and wait on it, praise God. If you ask him, wait on it, praise God. When you pray, depend that it's all left up to God. It's all depend on God this morning. And God will do it in the fullness of his time. He will work it out. You don't have to tamper with it. You don't have to mess with it, praise God. Just stand back and see the salvation of God, because God is working this thing out, praise God. He's working it out in your life. When the enemy says over, praise God, begin to praise God, to begin to lift him up, begin to magnify his name, praise God, because God is getting ready to work on your behalf this morning. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God this morning? Praise God, hallelujah, glory to God. And if you don't know him this morning as your personal savior, praise God, you can know him just by asking him to come into your life and repent of your sin. Have a contrast spirit, praise God. The Bible says you can believe in your heart that God has raised his son from the dead after 3 days, hanging on the cross, and took him down. After 3 days, he was in the grave, praise God. And he came up with all power in his hand, praise God. If you believe this, praise God, that he's now set on the right hand of the Father this morning, praise God, you can be saved, hallelujah, glory to God. Just ask him. And wait on God, praise God. God will move on your behalf this morning, praise God. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for another day, another opportunity, another powerful word, God, to go into our spirit, into our soul, into our mind, God, to work within us, God, to help us to wait on you, God. No matter how bad circumstance may be, God, you are still in control to work it out. Even when they said the deadline has passed, God, we believe that you can work it out, God, and we know that you can work it out. because you said that you will never leave us nor forsake us, God. You will work it out if we hold tight and firm to the faith, praise God. Hallelujah, God. And God, I pray that those that are listening to me now, God, will be blessed, God. Be blessed, God, for whatever trouble, whatever situation they're in, God, that they will trust you, God. Trust you to bring them through in the fullness of your time. In the mighty name of Jesus, and the body of believers said, amen. This morning, praise God. Hallelujah. This word has been a blessing to you this morning, praise God. Feel free. Text us, call us, let us know that God has blessed you through the word, praise God. And don't try to work out God's will before time, because God knows exactly when the perfect time for you this morning, praise God. Let us know that God has blessed you this morning, praise God. And if you want to be a blessing this morning to Kingdom Word Ministry, praise God, just text Kingdom Word to 22525, praise God. And remember, Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah.
I am safe there. Yes. And secure there.
Yes.
Not fighting for attention, fighting for affection. Yes. I belong there.
Yes.
You said I belong
there.
I said I'm never let go of your hand, Lord.